As the economy slowly begins to pick up, many businesses are still facing a rocky year ahead. Special correspondent Kat Wise has a story about one family-owned business that has taken one hit after another, but is hanging on with support from the community.
Happy moments from a time before masks and social distancing at Enchanted Forest, a small amusement park nestled on a wooded hillside just south of Salem, Oregon. Normally this time of year, the park would be filled with spring breakers. But after an exceptionally turbulent year, capped by a devastating winter storm in February, this unique and much-loved park is closed and struggling to survive. Enchanted Forest was built by hand by this man.
I'm Roger Tofty, creator of Enchanted Forest.
Tofty, who recently turned 91, purchased the park's 20 acres in the early 1960s while working as a draftsman for the Oregon Highway Department. He spent 7 years during his free time building the park's storybook-themed attractions and brought them to life with his artist's eye. In August of 1971, he opened the park to the public.
When we started, we didn't have too much. We had the Seven Dwarfs Mine and the Witch and things like that. I think it would charge 50 cents to go through.
Over the years, Tofty added to those attractions with the help of his four children and other family who now run the park. Around 100,000 visitors came each year, strolled through the quirky western town, got soaked on the log ride, and blasted evil characters in the Challenge of Mondor, which took Tofty 7 months to create. He took me for a spin on the ride during our recent visit.
Part of the ride is taking these blasters and aiming it at things?
Yes.
Okay.
They're infrared guns. And we shoot at these blue spots.
We shoot at the blue spots. I think I got one.
Tofty's oldest daughter, Susan Vaslev, is co-manager of the park.
How would you sum up the past year?
Challenging. You know, I just keep thinking it's another challenge, it's another challenge, it's another challenge.
The first of those challenges, the pandemic.
Before COVID, we had no debt. We were a thriving family business. You know, things were great. Then we were forced to shut down. So we had zero income coming in. And an amusement park is very expensive to run.
Later in the summer, when government COVID regulations eased up, they were allowed to reopen, but at greatly reduced capacity. Then came the wildfires. As the Beachy Creek fire encroached on surrounding communities in early September, family members scrambled to save important documents and memorabilia, unsure if the park would survive. And nearby, a family tragedy unfolded. Roger Tofty's 13-year-old great-grandson, Wyatt Tofty, and his grandmother were killed by the fire outside their home. Wyatt's mother survived, but was badly burned.
A horrible tragedy of trying to save Wyatt and Peggy and not being able to. The world could not have lost two more beautiful people, you know.
The Tofty family were hoping for a better year ahead, but damage from the ice storm set back their reopening plans.
Enchanted Forest is one of many small businesses around the country that have been devastated by the pandemic and other events over the past year. Many have had to get creative in order to survive, and that's what's happened here too. The Tofty family has reached out to the community for support, and there has been a big effort to save this beloved park.
In October, Enchanted Forest started a GoFundMe campaign, which has now raised more than $400,000 from nearly 8,000 donors. Many have taken to social media to express what the park has meant to them and their families. That money, combined with other fundraising efforts like a new Buy a Brick program and government COVID relief funds, have allowed the park to continue to operate, but just barely. Vaslev says they've had to let some staff go, and the park has taken on debt.
When you walk in, you just know that every piece was touched and made with love.
One of those rooting for the park is 23-year-old Selena Lopez Cruz, who worked at the park for 5 seasons and met her now husband there.
If Enchanted Forest were ever to go away, it's going to not be a loss to just me and my family, but it's going to be a loss to the whole community. It's just been a part of our community for such a long time.
There are so many similar institutions which are facing the same pressures.
University of Oregon history professor Vera Keller has been tracking what's been happening at Enchanted Forest and other cultural institutions across the state. She says if some don't make it, the impacts could be wide-ranging.
It's so important to our identity as Oregonians here in the state to have these places that we have had shared experiences in, like the Enchanted Forest. And it's around those places that we can come together, even when we disagree about, say, taxes or other political issues, there is an important social and cultural function that they serve.
Can you make it another year?
That's the big question. Until we are past the point where we have to social distance and sanitize between each rider, we cannot get back to normal.
For his part, Roger Tofte is optimistic about his park's future.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure it'll survive.
Tofte and his family hope to reopen later in April. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm Kat Wise in Turner, Oregon.
So important to see these uplifting moments in this pandemic.